हेलो। हेलो। शशि कुमार, कैन यू हियर मी? शशि,
यस मैम।
सुकन्या मैडम कॉल सेइंग दैट समथिंग इज बीइंग शोन ऑन यूट्यूब अबाउट क्षेमा ओरिएंटेशन। इज इट लास्ट ईयर? आई हैव टू
नो नो,
ओरिएंट माय
वी आर एडजस्टिंग इट। इट विल
ओके
बी रेडी इन अनदर 1 मिनट।
ओके ओके थैंक यू। शी गॉट मी कंफ्यूज्ड, आई डोंट नो व्हाट ही हैड। ओके
ओके।
तो यूट्यूब नंबर
यस मैम। या नाउ इट्स ओके। हेलो मैडम, मैडम
कंफ्यूजन ಮಾಡಿ ಹಾಕಿದಂಗೆ ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅದು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಸುಖ
ಒಂದು ನಾಳೆ ನಾಡಿದ್ದು ಯಾವ ಸ್ವಾಬ್ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡಿ।
ಸ್ವಾಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಸುಖನೇ ಉಂಟು ಗುದ್ದು ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ। ನಾನು ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಭಾಷಣ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ।
ನೀವು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಾಕ್ತೀರಾ?
ನೀವು ನನ್ನನ್ನ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿ
ಆಲ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮೇಡಮ್।
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು।
ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಬಿಡುವ ಇದು ವಾಯ್ಸ್
ಸಾರಿ ಸರ್ ಸರ್ ಇದು ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್ ಲೈವ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್
ಸರ್। ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್
ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್,
ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್ ಲೈವ್ ಸರ್।
ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್
ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಸರ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್।
ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಏನ್ ಚೊಳ್ಳೇದು ಅಂಚೊಳ್ಳಾರ ಅದೇ
ಸರ್, ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್।
ಹೌದು, ಏನ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಕ್ಲೌಡ್ 9 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ? ಹಿಂದೆ ಸಮುದ್ರ ಆಕಾಶ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಉಂಟು। ಕ್ಲೌಡ್ 9
ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವೈನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ವೈನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಗಿ
ನಿಮ್ದು ವಿ ಸಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಗಿಂತ ಪಾಶ್ ಉಂಟು। ಅವ್ರ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ವಿ ಸಿ ವೈಷ್ಠಿನೇ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ ವೈಸ್ ಚಾನ್ಸಲರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು। ಬೀಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್।
ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್, ಸರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ ಲೈವ್, ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಓರಿಯಂಟೇಶನ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ನೌ। Am I audible?
Yes, you're audible, Anshya. You're audible.
A very good morning to all the students, parents, and all the respected dignitaries present today. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the orientation program of Allied Science, undergraduate and the postgraduate courses. Am I audible now?
Yes, you're audible, Anisha.
Sorry for the glitches. Good morning to one and all. A very good morning to all the students, parents, and all the respected dignitaries present today. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the orientation program of Allied Health Sciences, undergraduate and the postgraduate courses. I wish to congratulate each student on securing the admission with the NITI deemed to be university. The university puts the student at the center of everything it does. Your experience and success are essential to each members who works here. Now I request Professor Dr. Sumalata R. Shetty, Coordinator Department of Anesthesia and OT Technology, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Anisha. Good morning to everyone gathered here. We are fortunate to have our respected Dean, Professor Prakash P.S., Vice Dean, Administration, Dr. Jayaprakash Shetty, and Vice Dean, Academic, Dr. Amrit Mirajkar, and the coordinators of the different programs, Masters in Public Health, Mr. McQueen Kenwood DeMello, Masters in Hospital Administration and Health System Management, Mrs. Anshya Rai, Medical Laboratory Technology, Mrs. Archana HV, Medical Imaging Technology, Dr. Raghuraj Upur, Respiratory Therapy, Dr. Girish Belur, Renal Dialysis Technology, Dr. Janardhan Kamath, Dr. Pradeep Shanai, Radiotherapy Technology, Dr. Jairam Shetty, and our librarian, Central Librarian, Dr. Supreeta, Mrs. Shashikumar Shetty, Student Counselor, Mrs. Srividya, Dr. Karunakar, our Physical Director, Kshema, heads of the different departments that are involved in the teaching and training of the Allied Health Science students, and most important, parents and students. Welcome to you to the 21-22 batch, both for undergraduate and postgraduate. As was told to you earlier by the registrar and then by the vice chancellor, today would have been a great day. It would have been a festivity all over the campus with us all prepped up to receive you and your awards. It's a great day for us because we are seeing a new batch, and for you and your children, they are new future. So unfortunately, because of COVID, we had to go online program, and hence here we are on the online. We from the departments and the institution, KSAC Medical Academy and the university, NITI University, welcome all of you to this program. And dear parents and students, your future is well secured in this institution under the NITI banner. And we hope to see you flourish into adults with your respective subjects and become masters in it and go ahead in this world to win your goals. And most important, we have with us Rachana. Rachana is whom you will all be meeting, the parents and the students. So Rachana is the manager of KSAC Day. And to all of you, including the faculty, teaching and non-teaching, a great welcome and thank you for choosing NITI University and our course and KSAC Day Medical Academy for your future. Welcome all. Thank you. Over to you, Anisha.
Sorry. Now I request our Professor Dr. Jayaprakash Shetty, Vice Dean Administration, Shema, and HOD of Pathology to introduce KSAC Medical Academy.
Okay.
Over to you, sir.
Good morning. Good morning to everyone. Respected Dean of KCDA Medical Academy, Professor P.S. Prakash, and all the coordinators of the Allied Sciences, whom I'll be introducing at a later date, my esteemed colleague, Dr. Mirajkar, and all the faculty and all the dear students, welcome you all to the orientation program on this beautiful day, which starts Navaratri and all holy festival in this month, begin with 1st October 2021. As you all join the alma mater of KCDA Medical Academy under the NITE deemed to be university, we have the long list of allied health sciences courses. To start with, the students of BSc and MSc of Medical Imaging Technology, Anesthesia and OT Technology, Respiratory Therapy and Medical Laboratory Technology, Radiation Therapy Technology, Renal Dialysis Technology, Master in Public Health, Hospital Administration and Health Systems Management, and also the Postgraduate Diploma courses in Computed Tomography Technology, that is CT Technology, MRI Technology, that is Magnetic Resonance Imaging Technology. All the students who have chosen their courses in the list of these allied courses, I wholeheartedly welcome you all to the portals of KCDA Medical Academy. To go through with a brief overview of your medical school, that is the KCDA Medical Academy, it started in the year 1999. Not only imparting the allied health sciences courses, the KCDA Medical Academy has an MBBS intake of 150 students, with broad specialty of MD-MS of 36 seats, and a super specialty course of urology, apart from the courses what I already mentioned. This is your medical college and the hospital. This is our beloved dean, Dr. P.S. Prakash, formerly the professor and head of the Department of Medicine. Now he's the dean of the medical school, a physician par excellence, loved by his patients, loved by his students, a disciplinarian, and a role model to all of us. I humbly, wholeheartedly introduce Professor P.S. Prakash, the Dean of KCDA Medical Academy. This is myself, and along with me, my colleague, Professor Mirajkar, a professor and head Department of Physiology, and a teacher who teaches all the students as they enter to a medical school or any allied health sciences courses. This is our medical superintendent, Professor Major Dr. Shukumar Hiremach, who has background with the Army, and he looks after our Justice KCDA Charitable Hospital. To give a brief introduction about the Justice KCDA Charitable Hospital, already the Vice Chancellor has said, this is an NABH accredited hospital, which is 1,000 bedded. In the way back, 99, what was started with 300 beds, now it moved to 1,000 bedded mega medical sciences complex with modern diagnostic facility, with the state-of-the-art laboratories supported by the MRI, CT scan, CAT lab, and all modern operation theaters. And as already in the introduction of the university, they might have told you, the hospital is NABH accredited, the laboratories are accredited by NABL. Hospital also has got an intensive care units. There is an emergency and trauma center, and in a year to start with, you have a full-fledged emergency medicine department going to function in this 1,000-bedded hospital. Apart from the hospital is geared up to take care of all the COVID care patients, including the ICU. There is also a newly added plasmapheresis facility in the blood bank. And since the COVID-19 testing is a mandatory requirement for all traveler, for all the patients, for all of us who have a symptom or to screen us, we have an NABL accredited COVID-19 RT-PCR laboratory, which is NABL accredited, and it starts functioning from the year 2020 and going on to function in the days to come. Justice Care Secretary Charitable Hospital not only caters with the broad specialty departments, it has got all the super specialty departments added to with that. There is a state-of-the-art cancer center. There is a surgical skill lab. What you cannot demonstrate in the patient or before going to the ward, one can elicit all the signs, all the symptoms with the different mannequins. It is located in the hospital. Apart from that, there is an IVF lab and IVF department. Probably the few medical colleges can boast of an IVF center in a medical college setup. Apart from that, there is a advanced neurological research center. There are a lot of, there is a multiple sclerosis society, which is probably the number one in the South India. And also there are a lot of researches going on in this advanced neurological laboratory. Added to that, there is a stem cell laboratory with the central research laboratory, which is housed in the medical college. Apart from this, the library is the mainstream, though the many are acquainted with the soft copies in the mobile or in the laptop or in your desktop. Nothing like sitting and reading in a library in your own concentration. If you can look at your library, one of the foremost equipped library with more than 18,000 books and almost 142 subscribed print and almost 3,000 odd e-journals and 3,000 odd e-books, and entire the medical college, the hospital, including the library, has got an internet facility, including the Wi-Fi, which is free of cost for all the students. Apart from this, there are 30 computer terminals, which is located in the medical academy, the college building, as well as in the hospital. Any student can access to this facility to update himself in the subject or in any symposium or any presentation which he or she likes to do in the departmental presentations. To begin with, we have the medical imaging technology, which has got MSc and BSc courses. The coordinators of this important course is Dr. Raghuraj, is a professor of radio diagnosis, ably assisted by Mr. Shashikumar Shetty. If you take the MSc course, there are 10 students per year. It is 2 years semester scheme. The BSc imaging technology, we have 30 students per year with the duration of 3 years and 1 year internship. Added to BSc and MSc courses in the radio diagnosis, we have newly introduced postgraduate diploma courses in CT, that is computer tomography technology, with the 2 students per year of 1 year duration. Similarly, the MRI technology with the 2 students per year, which is of 1 year duration. This program starts from this academic year, that is 21-22. Coming to the another important course, that is BSc and MSc, anesthesia and OT technology. Already you have seen the madam. She is the coordinator. She is the professor of anesthesiology, Dr. Sumalata R. Shetty. If you take our MSc program, we have 10 students per year. It is also a 2 year semester program. We have BSc students or BSc course with the intake of 30 students per year. And the duration of the course is 3 years with a 1 year internship. The medical laboratory technology, as I already tell you, the Justice Case Secretary Laboratory Services is NABL accredited laboratory. The course is run as BSc course as well as MSc programs. It is ably coordinated by Mrs. Archana. The MSc intake per year is 10 students with the 2 year semester scheme. The BSc medical laboratory technology, the 30 students per year with the 3 years program and 1 year internship. Coming to the respiratory therapy, we have MSc and BSc courses. MSc 2 students per year. The duration of the course, like other courses, is 2 years semester scheme. The BSc intake is 8 students per year with 3 years and 1 year internship. It is ably coordinated by Dr. Biridhar BH. He is the professor and head Department of Respiratory Medicine, and he is the coordinator. This year, we added a few more new courses, the radiation therapy technology. The intake is 5 per year, and the duration is 4 years, including the 1 year internship. This is coordinated by Dr. Jairam Shetty. He is heading the Department of Radiation Oncology. The another course which is started in this year is renal dialysis technology, that is BSc RDT. The intake in this year is 5 students per year. The duration is 4 years, including 1 year internship. The coordinator of this program is Professor Janardhan Kamath. He is heading the Department of Nephrology. The next course is Master in Public Health. The intake per year is 15 students per year with a duration of 2 years. The program is also has an unique exchange program with the University of Minnesota also. Few batches have come out with the flying colors. It is ably coordinated by Mr. McQueen DeMello, the Associate Professor, Department of Master in Public Health. MHA-HSM, the Hospital Administration and Health System Management, this program is started 2 years back with the intake of 10 students per year. The duration is 2 years. This is coordinated by Mrs. Anshya Rai. She is a lecturer in the Department of MHA-HSM. We have few other programs, which is what is called as the Namaste program for the Northeastern states, which is for Nagaland, Assam, Meghalaya, and Tripura, and all the Northeastern states are participating in these program where the dialectics are taught to the students who are from these Northeastern states, as well as students learning in these courses. There is a center for Tulu, because Tulu being the major local spoken language, the particular language is taught in these programs, apart from the MSME Business Incubator Center. As being the medical college and the university, we have got several collaborations and linkages which is spread across with the 25 nations and across 5 different continents. To name a few, we have a Goethe University Frankfurt from Germany, Penn State University, USA, Cleft Children International, Switzerland, Wake Forest University, USA, Catholic University of Korea, where I was mentioning the stem cell lab, Canterbury Christchurch University from United Kingdom. These are the list of universities we have linkages. Apart from that, the medical college and the university in particular can boost off a very good important social responsibility, which is almost having 19 rural health centers and 2 tertiary hospitals. The 19 rural health centers are spread across 3 districts and 2 states, the Karnataka and Kerala. There are 19 rural health centers, which is affiliated to the medical school, and 2 referral centers. One is at Karkala, another one is at Niche. The rural multi-speciality center, what I have mentioned already, is caters to the Karkala Taluk. Apart from our super specialists are visiting to that center. The rural psychiatry center is unique of its own, where the psychiatry services are extended to the rural population. Probably the K Center Medical Academy is one of its own in South India, having this program for the psychiatric patients in the rural area. If you go to the statistics, more than 2 lakh populations are covered in this program. Almost around 25% of these enrolled patients are treated free of cost. This is the social responsibility, which is by the K-Sekta Medical Academy, in particular, the NITE Education Trust and the NITE deemed to be university. Once you visit the campus is safe for you. There is a comfortable hostel facility for you, for the students, for the male students as well as female students. There are in-house wardens, there are in-house supervisors, ably assist you in all your day-to-day requirements. There's a vibrant campus facility. Because of the COVID, we are not meeting from last 2 years, but however, the medical college has a separate cultural program for allied health science courses. Each year you have a college day, you have a cultural day, you have a sports event, so on and so forth. Apart from that, there is a gym. Any student can use this facility that is behind the medical college. There is an auditorium. Down to that, one can see the gymnasium facility. Apart from that, there is a, what you can see over there, there is a basketball, there is a football courts where one can always go for the sports as well as the extracurricular activities. Apart from what I mentioned is, all of us are human beings. One or the other day, there may be a little, you know, little deviation from our day-to-day healthy life. Nothing to worry about it. There is a wellness center, which is for mainly for the students, which is ably assisted by Professor Srinivas Bhatt, the head of the Department of Psychiatry, and managed by the Mrs. Srividya, the counselor. Any student can walk in, share their problems, find a solution so that you can always remain cheerful in the classes, as well as in your hostels, as well as in your personal life. Apart from the medical school and the Justice K. Sekhri Charitable Hospital, which is one of the constituent college of NITI deemed to be university, these are the few more colleges which is attached to the deemed university, the A.B. Shetty Memorial Institute of Dental Sciences, the NITI Usha Institute of Nursing Sciences, NITI Institute of Physiotherapy, NITI Gulabi Shetty Memorial Institute of Pharmaceutical Sciences, NITI Institute of Communication, NITI Institute of Architecture, NITI University Center for Science Education and Research. Apart from the institution what I mentioned in this campus, we have one more vibrant campus at NITI near to Udupi, that is NITI Mahalingadhyantaya Memorial Institute of Technology, very old engineering college. There is also another management institute, that is Justice K. Sekhri Institute of Management. We have one more campus at Bangalore, that is another engineering college, NITI Meenakshi Institute of Technology, Bangalore, and NITI School of Management at Bangalore. As I said, it is the universities sponsored by NITI Education Trust. Under NITI Education Trust, these are all the colleges in three different campuses. One is here in Deir Lakatta. In few days to come, or by next month, you'll be entering here, one campus at NITI, an hour journey from here, one campus in the capital of Karnataka, that is in Bangalore. Thank you once again for all the students. I'm not personally seeing you here, but we will definitely meet you when you visit the campus. This is one of the alumni has photographed herself who has joined here, and in the years to come, she moved out with a flying color. So I put a photograph with our campus. Wish you all well. We'll wish you your beautiful stay with your academic career in 3 years or 2 years. Whatever the program you are taken up, our dean is there. We are there. Your coordinators also will be helping you. Our office also will be helping you in the days to come to have a better career in the campus. Thank you once again. Wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir, for the brief introduction of K. Sekhri Medical Academy. Now I request Dr. Karunakar Shetty, Physical Education Director, Shema, to orient us about the sport and extracurricular activities. Over to you, sir.
I'm audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Respected Dean, Vice Dean, dignitaries, parents and students. Good morning everyone. I am Dr. Karunakar Shetty, Physical Education Director of CHEMA, KSHA Medical Academy. I hereby welcome you all to NITI University Sports family. And for the next couple of minutes, I would like to brief you the sports activities, infrastructure, rules, regulations, and so forth. I will start with the sports facilities. Inside the campus, we have a sophisticated indoor stadium with the floodlight system for basketball, badminton, tennis, volleyball, throwball, table tennis, chess, carrom, etc. You can see the pictures. Outdoor facilities for athletics, two football field and one basketball concrete court and cricket nets. And NITI gymnasium. We have international standard state-of-the-art gymnasium with the centralized AC and very vast experienced two male and one female staff. Timings, morning 5:30 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Evening 4 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. If you are interested to access into it, what you all need to do is registration. Register yourself by filling the registration form, which is available at the gym, and need to sign under the declaration. You will have to have separate non-marking shoes and proper sports outfit. Formals or casual wears are strictly prohibited inside the gym and sports arena. Sports activities, intramural. Initially, we conduct intramural or interbatch events for all the indoors and outdoor sports, followed by annual athletic meet. The winners and the runners will be felicitated by the guests, and the best players will be selected to the college team. Extramural, we organize NITI University intercollegiate tournaments for all the indoor and outdoor sports. The constituent colleges of NITI deemed to be university will take part, teams will take part in this event. Winners and runners will receive the university certificates and medals. NITI Kridotsava. This tournament will be conducted for all the institutions under NITI deemed to be university and NITI Education Trust. All the colleges, teams will take part in this tournament. NITI accolades. We have been organizing South India level intermedics and dental sports tournament for 10 years. The different colleges of South India level will participate in this tournament. The cash prize, trophy, medals and certificates will be awarded to the winners and runners. We also organize NITI volleyball league, it's called NVL, and the CHEMA Premier League, it's for cricket. For the staff and students of NITI deemed to be university, the auction will be conducted to select the teams and the team owners will select the players. The college team has also been participating in the intercollegiate tournaments, which has been conducted by TMC Manipal, SGMC Kolar, JSS Mysore, Padamuls Mangalore, CMC Vellore, Ramaya Medical College, Bangalore, etc. With this, I conclude and I wish all the very best. If you are interested to take part in any kind of sports activities, feel free and join with us. I assure you, definitely we will add some good values on your playing ability. Thank you. Thank you very much. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Supeta Shetty, the Chief Librarian Shilma, to orient us about the usage of library facilities. Over to you, ma'am.
Respected Dean, Vice Dean, Head of the Departments, Faculty and Course Coordinators of Allied Health Sciences, parents and dear students, a very good morning to you all. Congratulations and a warm welcome to all the freshers who are now part of Shema family. During the next few years, you will need to use the library frequently in connection with your studies. So to enable you to make effective use of the library resources and to create an awareness about the library, here is a small presentation. This is the overview of my presentation. First of all, I will acquaint you with the location of the library, timings of the library, how to join the library, the resources available, how to find the books, the services provided, and the rules and regulations of the library. Our central library is situated in the second floor of the academy, and in each of the departments, we have the department libraries. The timings of the libraries are as follows: from Monday to Saturday, it will be functioning from 9 a.m. to 11 p.m., on Sundays and general holidays from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. These are the different sections in our library. We have a capacity of 350 seatings with AC. We have three reading halls. We have a digital library. We have a reprographic section and a staff and PG section. And we have the periodical section. So to take the library membership, first of all, the membership card will be issued in the library. So you need to provide two copies of passport size photograph in the library counter. So our campus is Wi-Fi enabled, and applications for Wi-Fi network connection can be collected from the library. So these are the library resources. We have books, print journals, e-books, e-journals, newspapers. We have CDs and DVDs. We have bound volumes of journals. We have access to the WHO publications and also the electronic databases. A library collection is automated and using the EasyLib software. So when you come to the library, you can easily search for the books as per the author, title, or keyword. Also, we have given links to all the databases that is available with us. Suppose if you need a book on Winthrop's, Winthrop's Clinical Hematology, you just have to put the keyword search and it will display all the books available and whether it is issued outside or where it can be found. So we have access to the e-books through JP Digital. And these are the services provided. We provide the reference and consultation service, photocopying service, and we'll be helping you all in the literature search. Whenever you want an article or any literature, you can always approach us, and we'll be ready to help you in the literature search for your project or any research work. We have the access to the previous university question papers, and we have access to HELIMED Consortium of RGHS. HELINET stands for Health Science Network, an electronic resource sharing consortium adapted by Rajiv Gandhi in University of Health Sciences to network all the health science libraries in Karnataka. And we have access to the full text articles of the international journals and books subscribed to this consortium. We have the subscription to UpToDate. UpToDate, it is a point of care tool. It supports clinical decision-making while treating patients. It has access to answers to clinical questions. We have subscribed to the Grammarly software, where the feature of this software allow grammar and spell check and enhance the quality of written material. We have subscription to Turnitin, It is an online text matching software which we can upload a piece of work to Turnitin. We get the originality report which enables the students to identify the area of matching text and copying. And Zotero, it is a free and open source reference management software to manage the bibliographic data. We will guide you regarding the use of Zotero for your research work and to manage the reference to do your bibliography when you go for publications. And this is the sample, when you upload to Zotero, this is how your reference comes, and it will help us in your reference management. And Delnet, our library is a member of the Delnet. It is Developing Library Network. It is a resource sharing network in India, and our institution is a member of this network. We have a digital library You can always come and use it for internet browsing and online journal access. We have facilities for preparing presentation materials such as slides, scanning, CD writing, and color printing. We also assist the students and the faculty members for editing their projects, theses, setting the file to required quality of print and printing. This is our library webpage where we have given links to all the e-resources subscribed. When you log on to go and mention Shema Library, this page will open and here we have given link to all the resources available in our library. And the transport facility for the library uses in the evening hours from the hostel is being provided. There are some rules and regulations you need to follow when you come to Shema Library. When you enter the library, you see that you scan your library card at the entrance of the library. Your attendance will be sent to the hostel every morning. And when you check in and check out, you should see that you scan your library. And the attendance maintained in the hostel should match with the attendance in the library. So you should keep your belongings at the property counter when you enter the library. The library card will be issued in the library to all the students. To refer to any book in the library, submit your reference card at the counter. For the undergraduates, books will be issued for 3 days and a fine of 5 per day will be collected after the duty. Reference books will not be issued outside, it may be referred in the library only. So you should not use, there are some restrictions for using mobile phones, no talking to each other, no discussion in the library. So all the books and journals, other materials are to be used with care, and you should not sublime your library card to others. Students, as I told you, the student attendance after the college hours will be maintained in the library, and this should tally with the register maintained in the hostel. So this is our library email ID. Please note it down. If you want any articles or any reference, you can just mail to this email. There are two email, I've given two email address. So you can mail to us, and please make use of the library. And I request each one of you to come to the library, collect your library card, and see what are the resources available, and let us all join hands to make our stay comfortable in this campus. So wishing you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Mr. Shashikumar Shetty, Assistant Professor, Department of Medical Imaging and Technology, to brief us about the rules and regulations of the hostel. Over to you.
Thank you. Respected Dean, respected Vice Deans, and respected coordinators of the different program, and my dear students. Today I'm just going to brief about hostel rules and regulation. Being a faculty warden of Allied Health Hostels, I'll just look into all the hostel rules and regulations at present in our campus. So as I mentioned, we have three different campuses. Already our Vice Dean, J.P. Shetty sir, I already showed different college in the different campus. So we have three different campus in the hostel within the 1 kilometer distance. So for all the hostels, all those things is the assistant director of the student welfare will be the in charge, and he's the Colonel Suren Subbaya. He'll be taking the lead in the hostel related issues. So related to hostels, if it is related to any work related to the hostel, you had to contact to the college office, which is situated in the ground floor in the college building. And all the payments such related to maybe mess fees, room rent, when you join, in the first day itself, when you join to the hostel, you need to come to the college office of the Kshema, and you need to pay there itself. You no need to reserve before. You no need to send an email to reserve the rooms or whatever. So you straight away, when you come to the college campus on a physical appearance, offline classes, when it start, you had to come to the college in the ground floor and meet manager, as already mentioned, Rachana madam, she'll be taking care of it. So the payment should be done between 9 to 3 p.m. So in between this timing, anytime you can come and approach in the college office. So as per the rules, which is bound by the NITA University, you had to submit an application. It is available in the college itself. And room, all other things will be allotted according to the availability in the hostel. And this amount can be paid in a DD drawn by the NITA deemed to be university name. Or can be, when you come to the college office, that will be briefed about you. And as the rules and regulation, no tobacco, no alcohol is allowed to the in the campus area, not only in the hostel, in the campus area. So non-hosteler, other than the hostelers, whoever may be visitors, is not allowed to enter the hostel room. There will be places given to the in the hostel areas. The person has to come there and they can discuss, or they can chat each other. Then it is not allowed to the hostel rooms. So visitor lounge will be, as I mentioned, it will be available, and the timing between beyond the 6:30 p.m. should be done. So as I mentioned, students are not permitted to stay in the rooms during the college hours unless any illness, any health issues, anything is there, or else they had to be in the classroom. In case any such incident about health issues, and should be informed to the warden, and or it should be taken permission before itself only. And if you wanted to vacate the hostel, or if you wanted to go out with a vacation, it should be taken a prior permission from the coordinator of the respective your course. Then that letter should be submitted to the warden. That is very mandatory. Without permission letter, it will be not allowed to go out from the hostel. So every day attendance will be taken in the evening at the room, in the room itself, and watching TV, other facilities will be provided. And to travel from the hostel to the college, there will be buses is provided by the college. And the mess timing, these are the mess timing. So breakfast you're supposed to complete before 9 a.m. It will be available 9 a.m., 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. And lunch between 1 to 2:30 p.m. And the tea break will be 4 to 5. And the dinner will be provided before 7:30 to 9 p.m. You should be completed before that. So as I mentioned before itself, only policy on substance abuse is we are very clear that it is from the free of alcohol and others and substance abuses. So this to whichever threaten safety, this all issues related will be taken a strict action against the students. So I think when you received the email itself only from the dean's office, that is mentioned about to submit the anti-ragging form. It is available in the website. And there are a lot of questions, a lot of phone call I received requesting for when we supposed to submit. That form should be submitted when you appear as a physically into the college campus and the offline classes starts. From that day onwards, within 7 days, you had to submit it in the college office, or you can hand out to the your respective course coordinator. So dear parents, guardians, please note, there is a Chaitanya software, it is available. where attendance of the your student, your daughter or son, it will be received to your mobile or email. So please always check your SMS, so that if your daughter or son is on leave or it is not attended to the classes, it means you will receive a SMS saying that this class hours from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. example, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. your word is in on absent in the this particular class, with the subject name also it will be appear in the SMS. So please follow that and ask that before, if it is any such things is received a SMS, please verify with your son or daughter. So as already our physical director has mentioned, this all the sports facility is just beside of the hostel. You all can utilize as per sir mentioned the timing in without any hesitation. So for even for the participating in the sports, all the facilities, transports, transportation facilities also available, you can utilize it. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The COVID-19 pandemic substantially led to increased media application that enabled teleconferencing, telecommuting, online learning, and social relations. The prolonged time facing screen, tablets, and intelligent devices increases the stress and anxiety. Handling the stress is challenging, and attending online classes, doing assignments, and presenting seminar in a virtual platform is becoming even more difficult. To deal with these challenges, now I request Ms. Srividya, Student Counselor, NITE Student Wellness Center, to orient us about the stress management and counseling provided in the university. Over to you, ma'am.
Good morning, respected dignitaries and students. Stress management and counseling. About this topic, I'm going to orient for a few minutes. College life is known as one of the most memorable years of one's life. So it is entirely different from the school life, as the students exposed to new experiences and things. And you also need to expose to the unfamiliar faces. So as a transition period, students may go through a lot of changes and challenges and mingling with unfamiliar faces. So all these challenges and new faces, each challenge will teach you the socialization, and it helps you to form opinions and independent thinking. As you have to be serious about your career, you need to make decisions that will affect your future all by yourself. So before going to see the common challenges in college life, we will see what is stress. Stress is the reaction of body and mind. It can be to the internal and external demands or any situation or changes. It can be real or imagined. People behave differently as they perceive the situation. So how you take the situation or how you perceive the situation, that creates stress. But we cannot avoid stress. Stress is part of our lives. So what kind of stress is necessary in our life? There is two types of stress, positive stress and negative stress. Positive stress enables concentration, it increases performance, and it energizes to do a particular work. So if it makes us more efficient. So it's very much needed for our day-to-day life. Whereas distress, when the person is distressed, he will be very inactive, there will be no motivation, and it reduces the efficiency and effectiveness. So finally, it leads to physical, mental, and behavioral problems. So when we say stress, there are three elements. Stressor, that is the stimulus or causes for the stress, and stress reactivity, that is how you respond to that stimulus, and strain. Strain is the outcome of the stress or reactivity to the stimulus. So the common stresses in everyone's life is like this: biological, it can be within the body, like toxins, and environmental, maybe the climate, heat or cold, Then psychological stresses, it can be the low self-esteem and feeling depressed, these kind of psychological stresses. And sociological, because of the relationships or social isolation, that can also add to our stress. Then philosophical, loss of goal in life and having no purpose in life or morality. So these issues can also create stresses. So there are two types of, two sources of stress, internal and external. And when we say external stress, everyone has undergone with these COVID-19 pandemic lockdown situations. So social distancing, isolation, death of the close people, then fear of contamination, no social gathering. So you cannot attend any functions, events, and cannot go outside, closed malls, and you cannot go for shopping. So all this has created or added on the onto the existing stress. Then checking media for updates. What is next? How about the future? And what is the status? So spiraling of what ifs in the mind. So that can also make us to addict to the media, and that also can add to the stress. Then for students, adapting to online classes, that is the major challenge, because for some students, the course might be new and subject will be very new, the concepts they cannot understand or they will feel tough. At this point, the assistance from mentors or some modification in the study method and having network of friends or intellectual network to deal with the academic problems or difficulties, that will be more helpful, and somewhere it will help to reduce the stress level. Then other common stresses in college life is family problems or family conflicts. So it's noted that many students who come from family issues or family conflicts, they will be experiencing very poor conflict resolution skills. That can add to the stress. Then homesickness, loneliness, then feeling of consistently lonely, then chronic unhappy with the relationships. So these are all the symptoms. Then relationship difficulties. The students who are having relationship difficulties often face the problems with roommate. So it can be because of the difference in approaches, attitudes, then the personal hygiene also matters. Then facing difficult people, like every person is unique. The personality traits also depends, like some people are introverts, some are extroverts, some are very dominant. So at this point, when the unfamiliar faces, when you are dealing with such people with different personalities, it is difficult to handle such people. So conflicts are very common, that might be internal or external. Then intimate relationships. So it's very much needed. Intimacy is very much needed. But what kind of intimacy is needed, that need to be understood. Because intellectual intimacy, when you are sharing your opinions about your career, about your goal, if you are discussing with the other person, so that can be considered as intellectual intimacy. So that is helpful. And emotional intimacies, when you have uncomfortable feelings or any emotions, you will be sharing with the other person, so that's also fine. But when it comes to the physical intimacy, so you need to put a boundary, because if it ends up with a breakup or it ends up with breakup, it can lead to abuse, and in the later part, it can lead to some other mental health issues. Then another stressor is the change in sleep habits. So oversleeping or deprivation of sleep, that can affect the cognitive functions, like judgment and reaction time. There will be some problem. So it affects the cognitive functions. Then diet habits. So you will be more attracted towards the readily available food, and having nutritious food is very, very essential. So sleep, then having nutritious food, exercise, and relaxing. So that is very, very essential for the healthy mind. Then overstudying also lead to some cognitive problems, like ability to retain the information and ability to recall. So their problems will occur. Then for some students, especially those who come from out of the state or country, adopting to the new environment will be a challenge because the climate, then language, then culture, food habits. So all these will be new for such students. So adopting to that might be a challenge. Then changes in responsibilities. For some students, it is the first time to own up their personal responsibilities. It can be related to academics or career choice, etc. Because you will be viewed as more matured when you enter into the college life. So you need to take your own decisions in some aspects. So that can be challenging. Then high expectations. Some students may set high expectations or themselves or from the parent side or family, relatives. But setting realistic expectations is very essential. Then students who have that perfectionism, they also tend to have stress. Then some students may procrastinate their or postpone their work and they will do at the last moment. So such students will experience or face time management issues. Then finally, it leads to academic failure. The students who have undergone with the adverse childhood experiences, then strict parenting or over pampered parenting, then academic difficulties and other particular situations often face the problem of low self-confidence or self-esteem. So this can also affect the stress level. Then lack of assertiveness, how to say no. So that is also impact on the stress. And this is peer pressure is another important aspect in the college life. Generally, students seek support from peers when they are in a problem. So what is peer pressure? It is wanting to be accepted by peers. Being involved in something which is not from your interest, but by your friend. But peer pressure sometimes leads to negative consequences. The negative consequences can be drinking alcohol, using drugs or smoking, which impact on the academics. So you will experience like you will follow irregularity or very unpunctual to the classes. You cannot focus on the studies. And finally, it affects your grades, low grades or bad papers. Finally, leads to academic failure. And it is in your academic aspect. And when it comes to the law, you may have to face trouble with the law. Then relationships also will be strained, like with the teachers, with the friends, with the family, parents, everyone. And not only that, but the overall health also, like physical, social, and psychological health also gets spoiled. How counseling will help you in such to face such challenges? Counseling will help you to get directions in every stage of life. It helps you to cope up when you face challenges. So when you come for counseling, you will understand or you will learn some coping skills to deal with all the challenges what you face. Then you will get many options to your problems. So when you come with a problem for counseling, you will be in the process of counseling, you will be enabled to see your problem objectively and you will get more insight into your problem so that you will get many options and enhances your skills to solve the problems. You will be empowered in the process of counseling and some skills you will have in yourself, but you will not be knowing it. So that potentials or that power or that skills will be reinforced and you will be empowered to solve your problems. Then non-judgmental. You may think that when we go to the counselor will judge on your part. No, it's non-judgmental. And about your problems, you will be taking the decisions and you will be facilitated to think and take think about many options. Then approach of respect and concern to the client. So when when you have different or different kind of problems, different problems, you may think like how to approach the counselor, how the counselor will think if I explain about my problem. So irrespective of your problems, the you will be treated with respect and dignity. Then confidentiality. Whatever you share and discuss in the counseling will be kept confidential, except the cases like self-harm and harming others. So immediate stakeholders will be informed in only in such cases. So overall, the counseling environment will provide you a safe and private environment where you can address concerns or specific behavior that you want to come out. Then this is a general misconception and stigma about counseling. And due to these misconceptions, many are not preferred to go to the counselors or any mental health professionals. So one misconception, for the first misconception is counseling is for people with serious emotional and mental problems. So only when you have serious problem, then only you have to go to the mental health professionals. So it is the misconception. As early as possible, if you approach the counselor, it is easy and easy to come out of that. And it will not require that much of sessions also. Then seeking counseling is a sign of weakness. Counseling or seeking support, it is a sign of strength, because only strong persons can voice out and take support. Then counselor will give solution or fix your problems. So there is a common notion that when we go to the counselor, they will provide solution to our problems. So counselor will not give you ready-made solutions, or they will not fix your problems, or they will not label you as mentally ill or emotionally unstable. And another misconception is counselor cannot understand you unless she has had similar experiences or is of the same background. Actually, they are the trained professionals with enough clinical practice. So they will be the experts to deal with the issues. Then NITTE Student Wellness Center, where we do provide guidance and support to the student community at our wellness center. So all concerns you will be all your concerns will be dealt in a confidential and relaxed way. You will get counseling for psychological, behavioral, and interpersonal issues, and also the referral services will be done in counseling center. Then activities to promote students' health and wellness. So the activities related to physical, psychological, and social well-being also available in a student wellness center. To support holistic development of students, we also organize different prevention and promotion programs. So this is about the location. It is located at opposite in the Kshema campus, opposite to KS Hegde auditorium, and Monday to Saturday is the working days, except university holidays. So all students, undergraduates, postgraduates, and PhD scholars of NITTE University can avail this service. And please note down this number, 9353904878. So you can contact if you want any appointments. And you can send message also. You can drop a mail at wellnesscenter@nitte.edu.in. Or in person also, you can come to the reception and take appointment. But when you come, please carry your college ID for the appointment. So all the best for your bright future. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Professor Dr. Giridhar, HOD of the Respiratory Medicine, to propose a vote of thanks.
Good morning to one and all. First of all, I would like to thank our Honorable Chancellor, Sir, and the officials of the NITTE University for guiding us all through our all endeavors. And I also thank the Dean Kshema for his constant encouragement and support. And I would like to thank Professor Dr. Jayaprakash Shetty, presiding officer for today's function, as he has been guiding us through all the courses and all the supports he has always extended. And I also thank the Vice Dean, Professor A.M. Mirajkar, sir. He's been crucial in finalizing the curriculums and all those things, continuous support. Thank you, sir. And I thank Professor Dr. Sumrata Shetty for delivering welcoming address for today's function. Madam has been extremely enthusiastic and she has been helping us all through. And I also thank Dr. Karunakar Shetty, Sports and Extracurricular Activities Director at NITA University, for explaining all the possible sports avenues available in the campus. And I would request students to make best use of these things. I also thank Dr. Supita Shetty for elaborately explaining about the facilities, the amount of books, the e-learning services, general access available in our library. And I'm sure, madam, your deliberation will help the students to make the best use of the library. I also thank our Associate Professor from Department of MIT, Mr. Shishikumar Shetty, for deliberating about the hostel rules and regulations. And I'm sure he will be helpful to you at all the problems you face at the hostel. And also follow the rules so that he's a strict implementer of the rules. Thank you, Mr. Shishikumar Shetty. I also thank Mrs. Srividya, Student Counselor, NITE Student Welfare Center, for telling about the stress management and counseling. It's very important. It's not that everybody will go through the stress. I'm sure most of you will enjoy this stay at the NITE campus. But whenever you people feeling a bit low, or whenever this thing is, madam is there to help you all. Thank you, madam. And I honestly thank all the coordinators of the various courses and the heads of the departments and the staff members for making this a very good success, and they will help you people all through your stay here. Most importantly, I thank the parents and the students for choosing NITE University to pursue their various courses, graduate from the NITE University, one of the prestigious deemed university in the country. Thank you again. Thanks all again. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Today, with the deep satisfaction, we, the family of Allied Health Science, like to conclude that there is no alternative to the hard work and dedication at this institution. We not only give our students the best, but also make a sustained effort to encourage them to have the mindset that is determined and passionate for success, and that to hold at the same maintaining the focus on social responsiveness. I wish you all a very success at NITE University, and I am confident that you will find it an enriching experience. There's a small announcement to all the students. The departmental orientation link will be provided to you by your respective email ID. Kindly join without the fail. With this, I, Ansha Rai, the coordinator in charge of MHA-HSM, sign off. Thank you all.